Yes, sir. We're officially back at it. Boog Nice coming at you with the Metacomb Mafex Into the Spider-Verse animated movie Miles Morales figure overview. Let's do it.
This ain't for no scalper. You a scalper? Then fuck out shit. This one for them real collectors. That's army building and posing figures. Marvel Legends. Imports. Mini Mafia I'm fucking with. Hype beast, we know about you. Stay buying figs, don't know about me.
All right, here we go. Want to take a quick look at this figure. I'm sure there's plenty of reviews out, but I just want to go over my personal thoughts on this figure and the tailoring and the spindly arms and legs and what have you. Out of the package, you know, I thought the figure was okay. I am going to tell you right off the bat that I'm not a huge fan of the clothing here. I think some things about it are good and some things kind of annoy me about the clothing. But this is how he came out of the package with the unmasked head, the sweater and jacket on, which is all one piece by the way, shorts, and the knockoff J's. If you've been watching my channel, you know that I believe Into the Spider-Verse to be one of the best animated movies of all time. I think it was a masterpiece beginning to end, and every aspect of it was amazing, phenomenal, stupendous. So this is Mafex's first venture into that particular movie, first figure from that line, hopefully the first of many to come. We know for certain that we're going to be getting Peter B. Parker, which is up next. We'll be getting Gwen packed in with the Spider-Ham. Hopefully they'll complete the core team from the first movie. So I will say his movement in the upper torso, the arms, is pretty good with the jacket on. You get almost a full range of motion. It's not really hindered at all. Now, as far as his lower torso, the legs, it is hindered a little bit. The pants are a little harder. The material for the pants are a little more rigid or rugged than that of the sweater and jacket combo. And to be perfectly honest, I'm not really a fan of Mafex's version of soft goods. I don't think it looks as good as it could. Now, with some primping and pressing and some finesse, you can make it look decent. There is bendy wire down the front of the seams and on the bottom half of the jacket, as well as on the hood. So with a little bit of patience and an eye for detail, you can make this figure or make the tailoring look better than it probably is. I mean, that's what ACBA is all day, every day. Miles is packed in with 8 sets of interchangeable hands, so that's 16 in total. These two are open with the fingers slightly spread. The left hand on this set, though, has a very small peg in between the thumb and the pointer finger. And then this mask here has a very small peg hole at the top of the mask, and you can actually plug that in. So that was a nice addition, because this mask accessory is something that Mafex has been doing since the Andrew Garfield Spider-Man release. But they never actually made it where it can be attached to the hand. So I do like that addition here. That was a really nice touch. But aside from that, he's got all the hands that Mafex normally offers. The thwipping hands. Hands that can be utilized for holding his spider webs. Open hands with the fingers spread. Hands with the magnets on it. And he's also got interchangeable feet as well. So he's got another set of the knockoff Jordans with the magnets on the bottom. And then he's got 2 sets of feet for when he's just in his spider suit without the extra clothes. One for regular play and another set with the magnets similar to that of the knockoff Jordans. He's packed in with this sort of half masked head where there's a neutral head sculpt on. Looks like he's frowning just a tad bit. And I will say that the likeness is definitely there on both head sculpts. I think they did a pretty good job. Past few times, even when I've been kind of upset with some of the figures overall from Mafex, they've done a decent job on head sculpts. And then he's also packed in with 2 fully masked heads, one here where the eyes look pretty normal, and then he has another look where the eyes are a bit more squinted. So obviously you can have a lot of fun with all the hands and heads. And it should be noted that the fully unmasked head and the half masked head share a particular neck where you have to remove the entire neck and head if you want to swap on the fully masked head, either one of those versions. And real quick before I get him undressed, I just wanted to give you a look at these pants. Again, I'm not a fan of the pants, not a real fan of how the inner portion of the jacket looks, but these pants, the way the belt, and there's a little Velcro strap here right where the crotch area is, that keeps the pants in place. I'm just not really a fan of how this looks if you don't have it covered properly. And again, if you don't just finesse it the right way, then it just looks kind of sloppy and disheveled and not as good as some of the maybe just plastic parts that we'll see or that we saw with the Marvel Legends version and we will later see with the Sentinel version. But yeah, the jacket can be slipped off easily by just removing his hands, putting the arms back, and just pulling the jacket off. It's pretty simple there. Now, taking off the pants is a little more difficult, but not really. Got to remove the feet and just kind of pull them down around his legs, just kind of ease them down. But there's a look at him without the clothes, but with the sneakers still on. So you can see, like I said, he's a very spindly little guy here. And although his limbs are really thin and seem like they're pretty delicate, I haven't really had any QC issues just yet. And the articulation seems to be working fine. It is a great range of motion on this figure, just as much as you would get or we have received on any prior Spider-Man figure from Mafex. Everything is there. Everything seems to be working. My one issue is the left knee. You can't hinge the leg outward as much as I would like, and that seems like it's a similar issue that I had with the Mafex Hush Batman, and I'm a little concerned about that. And there he is with the sneaker swapped off. I've had no issues swapping out the hands, although I have had to apply a little bit more pressure to get the hands to sit as flush as I would like them to on the peg. But again, even though everything seems like it is, or maybe looks like it's delicate, you can handle this guy like you would with any normal figure, and I think everything will be okay. So far, it has been. I honestly think I like the figure better in just his Spider-Man suit without the clothing. I feel like the clothing is a bonus, and you know, you can get some vanity shots or whatever the case may be. But just the articulation and the look of him alone just like this is cool with me. I like it. So definitely a lot of fun factor and playability with this guy. As more characters from the movie get released, it will probably up the fun factor and playability. But I must say, this figure hasn't really knocked my socks off, and I'm holding out to see what happens with Sentinel. The $20 Marvel Legends version was still pretty damn good, just didn't have as many options. But I am eager to get this guy on film and take a bunch of pictures and see how he looks on the gram, you know? So stay tuned for that. I'll get him up in the next showcase of me showcasing things that I've got recently, and I'll have plenty of pictures up on social media. So thanks for hanging out. As always, rate, comment, and subscribe. Hit the bell down there, and until next time, peace.
Enough for us. Listen here, Mace will make you disappear, and your mouth will be the reason that you missed this year. Man, who needs you? You don't need me, I don't need you neither. That's why my next leg's gonna be a two-seater.